Well, thank you for joining us. A lot of Republicans here in Florida and nationally are kind of scratching their head trying to figure out how they lost. They've named a five-member team to help them sort that out. And joining me now is Sally Bradshaw, former chief of staff to Governor Jeb Bush, and also one of those five people that's been spending an awful lot of time looking at the turnout and what happened. So give me a sense. You've been in Washington. You've been in Charlotte. Tell me what you know so far.
The five of us are traveling around the country at the request of RNC Chairman Reince Priebus, really to do a scrub of what happened during the November cycle, both, you know, nationally and at the state and local levels, and talking to as many people who are interested in the resurgence of the Republican Party about where to from here. So I think we collectively have spoken to several thousand individuals.
Wow, okay.
They may be state party chairmen, they may be members of Congress, they may be precinct committee men and women at every level. The RNC met for their annual meeting in Charlotte last week, and we were there and spoke directly with members of the committee about where we go from here and how we get there.
So, and are you analyzing turnout as well? And
we're looking at everything. We're looking at turnout. We're looking at data. We're looking at media purchasing and buying. I don't want to talk in some detail about everything we're doing, because I'm hopeful that it will form a roadmap for the future that the party can actually act on. But we're leaving no stone unturned to determine, you know, the best path, the best course of action for the party.
All right, so if someone who is a Republican or not wants to comment, there is a website on the Republican National.
There is. You can go to the Republican National Committee website, GOP.com, and there's a link, or you can go directly to the website for this Growth and Opportunity Project, which is growthopp.gop.com. And there is a survey there. We've had the survey in the field about a week, and over 34,000 people have responded to the survey. 10,000 people have offered to volunteer with the project, and so we're seeing great response. Great enthusiasm, great interest in helping the party move forward.
And what kind of questions are you asking there?
We're asking a lot of questions about what they consider to be priorities for the party moving forward. Does our messaging need to change? Should our tone be different? Do we need to do a better job, for example, some have suggested, with voter contact, which is an area, to the Democrats' credit, that they moved on very effectively in the last cycle, speaking directly to voters at the ground level.
Indeed, one of the things Democrats in Florida did, and the Obama administration targeted this, was actually turning people out, getting them to go to the poll or vote absentee, or by mail, actually, is what we call it now.
We've always focused on that as Republicans.
And actually,
there was a time where we had an advantage. They did, and I think we rested a little on our laurels, and they took it to the next level, where the contact became intensely personal. They also maintained a presence in battleground states for several years, as opposed to coming in the last 6 months of an election cycle and remaking those connections. And so there's certainly a lot to learn from the way they did that.
So you're suggesting they spent so much time getting to know communities and states that it was difficult for Republicans who came in late and had to start from scratch after 4 years.
Well, people are interested in their peers and what their peers think. And so it is easy to see why it makes sense that you are more likely to move on the suggestion of a neighbor, to act on the suggestion of a neighbor, than a stranger. And so they were in the communities, they were active participants in the communities at a political level, and it made a difference. There was a tremendous advantage on personal contact. We actually contacted more people than we've ever contacted before. I think we had, 10 million phone calls made in the state of Florida alone from the Republican side of the aisle. But the challenge is converting those contacts into votes. And we've always thought the more personal the contact, the more effective. They put their resources behind that concept, and it paid dividends.
All right, so give me a sense. Part of this report will be public, mm-hmm. as I understand it, but part of it obviously won't. Some of the nuts and bolts of what you think needs to change within the party, I guess, or give me a sense of what's there.
I think part of it will be shared with the 168 members of the Republican National Committee, so they can make decisions based on the roadmap we provide about where they want to allocate resources, how they want to allocate those resources, where to from here. And also, it needs to be public, so I think people know that we're taking this seriously. I really appreciate that Reince Priebus, the chairman, has come out and ask for a thorough review, because when something doesn't work, you should review it. You should see what you
well,
did well
and
what
he's been reelected. It's kind of interesting that he's willing to have people second guess
what
he did.
He is, and I think that says a lot about him and about the future of our party and where he'll lead it. But obviously, some of it we're not eager to talk about because it's strategic in nature, and I think you will see a component of it that really is a campaign plan of sorts. reports that they'll have to make decisions based on.
All right, so everyone's already starting to talk about 2016, and there are two Floridians at the top of the list for a potential nominee of Marco Rubio and Jeb Bush. You got a feel for that?
I don't know what either will decide to do. I like and respect them both, and I think it's very, very early to be having those conversations. I do think what's exciting now, that both Governor Bush and Senator Rubio are talking actively about immigration, and that's an issue that is very important, as you know, here in the state of Florida, but not unique to us. Our party has been a leader on this, and I think the president, actually, who came out with a package recently, is benefiting from the fact that we have people on our side of the aisle who are willing to stand up with him and maybe go in a different direction on immigration. That will be helpful.
Is it your sense that that issue was very topical over the last few years? Is it your sense that the Republicans seem divisive on that at some point? Is that one of the recommendations?
Not so much. I mean, this is something that Governor Bush and Governor Rubio have been talking about for years, and you saw them actively campaigning not just in South Florida but in Central Florida among, for instance, Puerto Ricans and the Puerto Rican community, Mexican Americans, reaching out to Haitians, reaching out to immigrants from all over our state because Florida is a melting pot. And I really think we've not been silent on this. We have had two folks who have led the charge, but the president, for whatever reason, although he did talk about it, never acted on it in his first term. And perhaps things have changed in his second term where he feels he can be a little more open to compromise, a little more willing to work with the other side.
All right, well, Sally Bradshaw, thank you so much for being here and sharing with people of Florida exactly your role in what's going on and where it
may
lead.
Thanks for having me.
All right, everyone else, stay with us. When we come back, we'll talk a little bit about Governor Scott's budget announcements.